My sister Yvette will be accepting the award. Where is the award, actually? I don't have an award. Thank you, sister.
It was beautiful. So, a little shorter. Thank you, Tafari. Tafari has brought new energy and grassroots activism to the AFL-CIO, and we are so very proud to have him as one of the three principal officers of our federation. It is a particular honor tonight for CWA to be recognized on the same program as Congressman Miller. He has been such a good friend to CWA, and his leadership and advocacy over the years has made such a difference for workers, and we thank you. I also want to thank Judy and the ILRF board for this recognition of CWA's international work. Regretfully, Larry Cohen, president of CWA, could not be here tonight to accept this award. But as Tafari said, much of our union's groundbreaking international work is a direct result of Larry's vision and commitment to long-term cross-border union-to-union work. More than 20 years ago, CWA began working with STRM, the Mexican Telephone Union, an outstanding, independent, courageous, and principled union. We started by putting on a joint organizing training. CWA taught half of it, and STRM taught the other half. From there, we moved to specific organizing support, including sending several of our Spanish-speaking organizers to Mexico and providing some funds for the work. For the last 10 years, STRM, with our support, has been organizing Atento, which handles customer service work for Telefonica, one of the largest multinational telecom companies in the world, as well as US companies like American Express. In the course of our research, we discovered that Atento had over 18,000 workers spread out all over Mexico City in different call centers. The workers along the way have faced harassment and intimidation, firings, and some sweet victories. Through the ups and downs, the organizers and the workers remain committed to forming a union, and we remain committed to stand by their side. More recently, we have been partnering with STRM on trade and immigration, linking the destruction of subsistence agriculture in Mexico with the forced migration across our border. This has allowed us to engage on the immigration debate here in this country with a fresh perspective and a new voice. There are practical payoffs for grassroots, long-term, cross-border work. CWA's effort to help workers at T-Mobile organize a union here in the United States has been greatly enhanced when Verdi, the German telecom union, agreed to form a joint union, a CWA-Verdi union, which we named TU. T-Mobile is owned by Deutsche Telekom. And in Germany, as has been said, in Germany, Deutsche Telekom has a respectful and constructive relationship with its union, Verdi. But in the United States, it is a different story, and they are actively and aggressively anti-union. TU currently has 1,000 U.S. members, and we have active partnerships between U.S. call centers and German call centers, between Dusseldorf and Nashville, between Dortmund and Wichita, between Berlin and Charleston. The workers talk with each other, they exchange experiences, and most importantly, they support one another. When an active TU member here in this country, Josh Coleman, was fired from his T-Mobile job because of his union activism in Wichita, 4,000 Verdi members in Germany all wore red shirts to work, with Josh's photo on the front and the words, "We are all Josh." When we showed Josh the photos of those thousands of Verdi members wearing those shirts with his face on the front, he fell to his knees with emotion. When we couldn't get a first contract for a small group of T-Mobile technicians in Connecticut, two top Verdi union officers came and sat by our side at the bargaining table. The Verdi officers were shocked by what management was saying across the table and by their behavior, and they went back to Germany and talked to Deutsche Telekom, and 3 weeks later, we got a contract. At the 2012 Verdi Congress in Germany, the leader of this 2 million member union ended his introduction of Larry Cohen by saying, "We used to send our young activists to Nicaragua to see what the world was like for union activists. Now we send them to the United States." So if there's one thing I would leave you with tonight, it is that cross-border work and solidarity is no longer just about us helping workers in other countries form union. It is just as likely to be about unions in other countries helping us organize. Solidarity forever, and thank you very much.